Gospel AM 1490 WMBM. Streaming live 24/7 at www.wmbm.com.
Amen, amen, amen. Gospel AM 1490, WMBM, WMBM.com. Well, family, you know, it is Thursday. It's the last Thursday of 2021. Deb Toomer here, of course, along with my wonderful co-host, Novice Johnson, and time for Ladies Day Live on WMBM. As we get started today, we just are so grateful for all that has happened in 2021, and we're especially grateful today for our very special guest and our sponsor, the Spirit of Love Christian Church in San Bernardino, California, under the leadership of the illustrious founding senior pastor and our friend, Bishop O. Kenneth. How about that? Ken Wells, we thank you so much, my brother. Love you so. We want you to definitely log on, family, for our sponsor's information to spiritoflovehouse.com for more information. Now, as you know, this has been a very, very special year. And we are just so grateful for all of the Ladies Day special guests. And today, this is really just the icing on the cake that we are able to feature this wonderful woman of God. How are you feeling today?
I am doing well, Deb, and thank you. And my sentiments exactly for all of the statements that you have just made. And we are so thankful here for all of the support for Ladies Day Live, all of our sponsors, all of our guests. Just keeping this wonderful ministry alive, and so glad that today we do have a very gifted and blessed First Lady with us. She's a Grammy award-winning artist. She's a wife and a mother, and there's just so much more that we're going to learn about her this morning. So once again, we thank our audience for joining us. And you know, one thing, she hasn't lost sight of her mission to support and uplift her community, particularly women of color. So we're ready to find out about this great woman, Deb.
Absolutely, absolutely. And Nava, again, thank you so much. You've just taken us to a whole nother level here. So we must always give honor where honor is due. So I appreciate you, my sister. And we're going to move right on forward into this conversation. And you know, this was just a treat. This was just a treat because I am so blessed. I'm going to give a bio, but I just have to start off with this personal point of privilege. I was so blessed to meet Lady Shervon Wells in London at the wonderful Gospel Summit that we attended along with her husband and so many others from around the world in October. And as we go into this conversation, you'll understand why I'm so happy. I'm so happy. Of course, Shervon Wells is commonly referred to as the soprano of life. Shervon Alicia Wells' journey in music and entertainment began in Los Angeles, California. Her God-given talents have manifested in many areas, and her gifts have definitely made room for her. Shervon has a true passion for music and ministry. Her sensitivity to the voice and call of God has allowed her to become a highly sought-after, anointed psalmist, speaker, and conference facilitator. Shervon has toured worldwide in Europe, Italy, and Japan, and has ministered for Bishop T.D. Jakes, Pastor Paula White, TBN, Reverend Jesse Jackson, Kirk Franklin, Fred Hammond, Buck Norfolk, James Fortune, the legendary Pastor Andre Crouch, Jay Moss, and she is a former member of the Grammy-nominated Stellar and BET Award-winning group, the Kirk Carr Singers. She's best known for Jesus Can Work It Out, and we're going to hear that because we know he can work it out this year and beyond. This lady's gifts don't start with singing. She has acted in leading roles in stage plays with famed actors Jacquet Harry, Michael Collier, Sid Burston, and David Whitfield. In addition to having a successful career in music and entertainment for 25 years and more, Lady Shervon has been serving in ministry as a pastor's wife. She is married to Bishop Kenneth Wells, who is a founder and pastor of Spirit of Love Christian Center in San Bernardino, California, and again, of course, our friend. She is also a doting mother of three wonderful children, and four beautiful grandchildren. And ladies and gentlemen, if you see this beautiful gift, she is an angel on earth. When she sent the photo over and I met her in person, she is that. We welcome you, my sister, in success. We thank you so much for joining us this morning. Good morning, 5:30 in California.
Yes, ma'am. Good morning. I have to first say good morning to Ladies Day Live listeners. And thank you, Deb and Novice, and especially Bishop Curry, God, we ministered at Bishop Curry's church like many times. So please let Bishop Curry know that I was on this morning if he's up and listening. But thank you so much, and to everybody at Gospel AM 1490 WMBM, thank you so much for being letting me be on with you this morning. I'm excited.
Well, we too. And Novice, we are just excited to move on with this segment. God bless you, sis. Novice?
Yes, I am so very, very excited, and she is beautiful inside and out. And Lady Wells, thank you for joining us this morning. Welcome to our Ladies' Day segment. Now, we know that you are such a gifted, accomplished artist. You are a leader in your community as a first lady and as a mother and as a wife. And sometimes I just have trouble balancing my day-to-day. Please share with us, how do you balance all that God has called you to do?
I think the most important thing is to have people surrounding you that can support you. Because for so many years when I was traveling, the traveling got to be like so much where it was pretty much every weekend. And at that time, I want to say after we recorded our second project, especially the second project with Kirk Carr, our career just took off. So every weekend, pretty much, I was on the road. So I would, of course, leave a bag packed with all the essentials and just change the clothes. That's how I was living. So it's just like you leave your essentials at home that you know you're going to need, but those same things that you know you need, you pack those things. And because I had children and a husband, and we had started the church, and it was just a whole lot going on. But God just blessed, and we have people. I had people surrounding me, because there were times when I would miss a lot of holidays, and they made sure that the kids' birthdays were taken care of. So I think just knowing, asking God to just give you what it is. How do I keep my schedule? How do I keep myself healthy in the midst of everything? How do I do all this? And God will give you the solution. You know, he started teaching me how to, like, cook. If I know I'm going to be gone all weekend, you know, just cook and just make sure that your family is taken care of. And then the Lord just blessed that one of the ladies from the church, one of the mothers, she ended up moving in, so she was able to help with the children and everything. So it just, God just started sending people. And I think that's one of the things. Everybody needs a Jonathan. Everybody, you know, like David, everybody needs somebody. So that kind of helped me out a whole lot.
Wow. And Lady Wells, that is so powerful, because so many times we just try to do it all ourselves. And as you just said, God has directed you to just allow others to do in his order to assist you and do what needs to be done, because we're moving and working in his kingdom. As we go on in the conversation, would you share a bit about one of your signature experiences, and then, of course, provide your contact information so we can certainly let our listeners know how to reach out to you. And this is not the last time you will be on WMBM. God bless.
Let me go back just a little bit, you know, because I had so many highlights, and I knew we were going to talk about that. And I'm like, well, there's so many things I don't want to forget, but it's like too many. And you know what? When you talk about highlights in your life, it always seems like you want to talk about the great things that happened that catapulted your career, or, you know, things that just, you know, put your signature, put you out there. But a lot of times the things that are highlighted are the things that God will allow to happen in your life that will kind of shake you and let you realize that it's God that got you where you are. It wasn't anything that you did. One of those things was, I remember we were in New York City on 9/10/2001. If you can just imagine, we were there the day before 9/11 happened, and we had performed. And so me and Kurt were talking, and we were just like, you know, when you're in New York City, you got to go shopping. And we said, well, let's just change our flight and let's go tomorrow, which would have been 9/11. So we were looking at the flight, and God, that song that we did, God blocked it. that thing is real, because there were no flights and we couldn't get a flight change. So we were like, well, okay, we'll just go home. So we left on 9/10, and I remember looking out the window that morning, the flight going back to Los Angeles, the United flight going back to Los Angeles, was the exact same flight that flew into the towers. So I remember looking at the Twin Towers as the plane took off. We can see them over the clouds, not knowing that that would be the last time. So when I say that, that was a highlight, because God did something that day, and every year when it comes, 9/10, I just get emotional. And a lot of people knew I was in New York, and the phone just began ringing, ringing, ringing. Did I make it home? And God let us make it back home. And so that was a highlight. Some other things, being able to sing at Michael Jackson's funeral, that was really a highlight, because, you know, everybody loves MJ. And I was wanting to do it so bad. And because of my connection and me being able to sing with Pastor Andre Crouch, who I just love dearly, that happened. So that was a highlight for me, just being in that atmosphere at the Staples Center. Even just singing with Pastor Andre Crouch was a highlight, because I grew up as a little girl just following his music, and I loved Andre Crouch's music, all that Bow Down and, you know, songs we don't really sing anymore, but those were songs I grew up off of, you know, Tremaine Hawkins and Change, things like that. And to be able to just be a part in ministry with these people, and of course the Kurt Carr singers, I can't go without talking about Kurt and being a part of the group. And the way God put us together, that was just, that was amazing. So a lot of times being in the right place and just allowing God, God's timing, you know, is everything. Because of being with Kurt, God always opened doors for us, and it wasn't always in the church. Because to me, it's not a highlight career if you are just being an entertainer and no one is being touched or people's lives aren't being changed. And I know that Kurt writes songs that change or that just do something to the world, because God has given him that gift. But even in personal ministry, my thing is, if we're not touching people's lives, you know, when you get off the stage, and a lot of times people know me for, they'll go, my God, you're the one always has those shoes. You know, they know I love shoes, or, you know, fashion and things like that. And I remember getting off the stage and being in concert, and this young lady, she was just like, your outfit is so cute. And I said, you know what, hold on, because we always had, you know, had to bring clothes, because by the time we got through ministering, we would always be wet. I said, if you don't mind, you can have it, you know, because things like that don't matter, you know, you just never know what to do for somebody else. And she let me go change my clothes, and I brought the outfit back. And if you could just see the look on her face, whether it was a hat or a pair of shoes, I didn't mind, you know, going into somebody else's life, because God has always given me more than enough. And I'm always, you know, realize I'm blessed to bless somebody else. I've been able to act in like plays, and I love that, because it just stretches my ministry, you know, beyond just being able to sing. So that was a highlight for me when I did the first play. I did the Michael Matthews play. If you remember, he was doing plays before Tyler Perry. You know, he was already out there.
Yeah.
So
yes.
Those were just, you know, I can't name them all, but just knowing that people look at your career and they there's something that they can glean from it. USC has a gospel. They wanted to put some people in their gospel hall of fame. If you can believe it or not, USC is known for football, but they have a gospel hall of fame, and they were like, we want you to be in that because you are just such a legend to us, you know, in this area. I grew up in Los Angeles, and it's just, it means a lot, you know, when you people can see your life and see what you do. And people just want to be a part of that somehow. So that's just a few things that
Amen. 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 And so powerful. And Lady Wells, of course, you just never know who you touch. And you just, I just highlighted, just as you just said, that you never know what your ministry does and how you bless. And you are just a beacon of light and hope in this wonderful world. Novice?
In case you've just joined us, we are talking with the incredible Lady Siobhan Wells, the First Lady of Spirit of Love Christian Church in San Bernardino, California. All of our new friends and listeners from that area, we welcome you. And you can check them out and support their ministry by logging on to spiritoflovehouse.com. Again, that's spiritoflovehouse.com. And Deb, I know that Lady Wells has so many great stories to tell us, but we're sure that you have a question you'd like to ask her before we close.
Absolutely, absolutely. And Lady Wells, we just need more time with you, so we're going to definitely have you back in 2022. We'll check your calendar, and thank you, Valencia, for making this happen. Of course, Bishop Wells and our wonderful family there at the church. Lady Wells, as we close out, we just want to ask you one more question, and then we'll finally ask you to certainly give a word of encouragement going into 2022. And on Ladies Day, we always look at powerful women. And tell us which women in your life influenced you the most.
Thank you, Deb. I would have to, number one, I would have to thank my mother. May she rest in heaven. My mother is definitely an influence, and my grandmother were great influences in my life. She made sure, because I grew up a Kojic girl, and they made sure, you know, that I stayed rooted and grounded. And in the Word, it just helped so much. She taught me, you know, how to be a lady, how to dress, how to look, and just how to treat other people. And I can't forget Vicki Mack Lataya. I love her so much. She was the executive, the CEO at Gospel Centric Records. And she's just a great influence. I still, to this day, follow her. I just, you know, every now and then get a chance to see her, just love on her. But these are great influences in my life of powerful women, women of God, that just helped me become who I am today. And even there are women, even in my local church, that I know kept me lifted up in prayer, the mothers in the church, and I just want to say thank you to them. So those, I would say, are women that just influenced my life in a special way.
Amen, amen. And I would just want to thank you again so much, Bishop Wells, our entire family there, for joining us today. And, of course, on behalf of Bishop Curry here and all of our family members at WNBN, we thank all of our listeners for more than 26 years of success. Certainly, we wish you the very best in 2022. And just close out with a word for us. We want your voice to be the last voice on this segment of Ladies' Day. To God be the glory in 2021 and going into 2022. First Lady Wells, close us out today. Thank you so much for joining us.
Well,
we love you.
Thank you so much again, Jeb and Novice and to Bishop Curry. And to all the Ladies Day Live listeners, let me just say this. God is not shocked at what's going on in 2021. Even when 2019, 2020, everything that we're going through right now, it has nothing over the God that we serve. So keep your eyes on God. Keep your eyes focused. Stay in this race, because the race is not given to the swift nor to the strong, but to the one that endures. These are trying times. These are times when so many people are going through so many different mental issues, emotional things, and it could take you on a whirlwind of emotions, what we're dealing with. But I'm telling you right now, that if you will keep your eyes on Jesus and look to him, Psalm 91 is a reality, that God, he is yet sitting on the throne. He's sitting high and he's looking low. You can make it. Ladies Live, be encouraged today. Be encouraged today. I love you so much. And thank you again for allowing me this opportunity to just share with the Ladies Day Live listeners. God bless you, WNBN.
Amen. It is so. Blessings, blessings. Back to you, Greg. Ladies Day Live 2021, going into 2022. Tell you what you ought to do. Tell you what you ought to do. He can work it out. He can work it out.
It's Throwback Thursday on Gospel AM 1490 WMBM, WMBM.com.